is a story about a museum of consciousness.
The robots have gotten pretty good at what they do, but they can't give an item a human touch. On Etsy, you can find
Thank you. Alright, y'all. Hey, hey. I apologize for being late. I had a friend. I was meeting with a fellow composer out here who I'm also in a band with to literally talk about electronic stuff. A particular realm that I do not often delve into. And they brought up this this creator here named Spangle. And so that's why we were listening to them. So this is our warm-up stream. This is a warm-up stream. Basically, what I do in a warm-up stream is I focus on something and I give myself an hour to create a piece of music around it. I like to use this time to kind of create some marketing materials for myself. If it's good enough, I'll post on my Twitter with a video. Yeah. So what we've been doing the past few times, past few warm-up streams, is create music with GIFs, with video games that I find on Twitter. But I think I'm gonna take a different approach today. I've got a few projects I got a few projects that I'll be working on. Hold on, I'm gonna close my door. I got a few projects looming in the shadows, and each kind of in different genres. One's reggae, one is going to be like a piano electronic hybrid, another one, don't really know yet, but I'm pretty sure it's going to be an orchestral music electronic hybrid. And you know what, I need to start doing some more synthesis and going a step further than what I've done in the past, like really trying to get good at creating stuff. So what I want the focus for today to be is synthesis. And I think what I want to do, because trying to force myself to create something and start and create synthesized sounds from scratch is daunting. I'm just not good enough yet. I don't know how to think of a sound and then go and instinctively know how to create it. So what we're going to do, our focus for our warm-up today, is using synthesis. Synthesizing, modular synthesis. I think what I might do is two sounds. I can use presets, but they have to be manipulated. So I can't just use default presets. I could choose them, and then I got to manipulate them. And then I got to make one to two. I want to push myself, but one to two. At least one a modular synthesis that I create from scratch. And what we're going to do is use a prompt from Reddit to do that today. So we're going to do something a little different. Modular synthesis, I can do anything else outside of that, but if I want to record something, stretch an audio file, I could do that. But I really need to focus on synthesis today, and just screwing around with that. So we're going to go to Reddit writing prompts, and I'm going to make this bigger for us here. And there tend to be a lot of really cool prompts that are shown here. Normally what I do is I randomize it. So I go to the filtering drop-down box, hit new, and the first thing that pops up is what I create a theme around. So our theme for today is going to be: a man sits in a burn ward due to a rampaging Charizard. A woman lost half her hand from frostbite due to dugong, and a child is in a catatonic state from swimming too close to tentacrul stingers. These are the untold stories of the Pokemon world. Okay. All right. So got a Pokemon reference. So I'm going to have to throw Pokemon in here. Put the Pokemon theme. Dun, dun, dun. Dee, diddly, dee, diddly, dee. Okay. So these prompts are pretty cool because these prompts are cool because I end up taking a more the approach I take, I feel, is more suited to film, where rather than it be a, if I'm doing video game music, where it just feels like I'm creating this chunk that can be looped over and over again, this one definitely feels like it'll have a beginning, middle, and end to it. So, what we're going to do, we're going to go ahead and get our synths out. I know that I, like I said, I want to have the Pokemon theme in here somewhere. Trying to think of how I want to convey this, since it's going to need to be conveyed with electronics. I could take it seriously as well. Another thing I tend to do for prompts like this is I kind of look at it from a film perspective. Like, if this were a scene in a film, how would I score that scene? And I guess a part of me is kind of like, let's see, I'm a man has a burn word. I think I kind of see it as like very, almost like you see these people sitting in these situations, right? Like, I'll try to describe it. What I'm seeing is a man in a burn ward, but like the tone of the film is very dark and gray and very sad looking. And like the camera is like kind of panning out, you know, like, and then the scene will switch to, you know, a woman whose hand is shaking, right? Like there's a dugong that she like killed, but like she's losing her hand, and you see the dugong there, and so like you see the camera like showcasing her, and it's panning out, and then it cuts to, you know, a child who's like a mother who's holding her child crying, you know, so it's very sad, very freaking sad. All right, so let's start with, so I have the film, I have the scene set in my head. Okay, well, sounds I hear that sound. Sounds like that, like a wah. Let's see. So I hear a very big swooping path that just goes. And so first thought is, it's definitely a sine wave. We definitely have, and there's going to be some pitch shifting, or like, two things could happen. I could have be to where it starts, yeah, and I kind of program it to where the pitch changes as soon as I hit it. What's that look like? Okay. One, two, yeah. And I think I want to fade out as well. I slow the tempo down. Da. Very slow. Okay. Oh, there's one. Oh, one, two, three, four, yeah. How are we? what I'm hearing. Oh, it's very slow. Oh God, that goes for forever. Okay, I don't know if that's what I want. I don't want it to be tied to tempo the whole time. Like, I want to be able to, like, maybe. I want it to be glissando, but I want it to, like. I want to be slow, and I want to be able to control. Aporta here. Oh, it's Porta. See, I feel like I know what I'm doing, but I don't. Porta. Okay. Like, you see how I'm spending so much time on just this one concept? This is, Already been 20 minutes. Like, I know this is so bad. So we're gonna change it. I'm just gonna have it be one thing that I do, that I try and synthesize. Alright, so let's... We're gonna leave this, because I'm gonna end up spending the whole time just working on this. This is gonna be deep. Oh no, you deep synth. I want the deep synth slide. Let me get pads. Synth. Ah, okay, I got more ideas here. I want like a. I want an arp like that. Okay, so we can use a preset, but we have to alter it. So let's. I don't like that scorgy sound. I think this might be the culprit for the a sign as well. There we go. All right, I like that. We're gonna make you an automation clip. No. Oh, it sucks I can't do that. We'll start here. I don't need that. as this fits. I don't know if, I'm trying to think of the scene again in my head of like just people. I think, geez. Okay, until I can figure out the deep synth slide, I want to. I kind of have an idea of the sound I want in my head, and I can't replicate it with synth just yet, so I just kind of want to get it out here. I don't know. No, I don't want that. Melodic. Is it India? I guess when it was. It was the Middle East. No. Something I had here. Middle Eastern string, that's what it was. I wish there was a glissando option. Mapping. I'll see. What we got. So I want this deep synth slide. I don't need the long sustain here. All right, so let's go to the main. Something really harsh. We don't need that. The volume here. I wonder why attack. I don't want the hit to be so harsh. Let's do attack. Hold on. Now we're getting somewhere here. Okay, we're gonna go main, change the pitch here. We're getting somewhere, all right? Yeah, I'm getting excited, y'all. I'm getting excited here. Okay, let me see something. Y'all. No. I gotta change that. Oh, doing volume wrong thing. Okay, we're getting somewhere. There we go. I don't like. Okay. Okay. Kind of getting somewhere. Let's do the filter going. Go to next filter. I want to be a little bit. Right now it sounds muffled. I think it's because of this. Why do we have that meow? I don't want that. Oh. Like it sounds a little muffled. Like it's, I want to open it up a little bit. Don't I add something else to it? There it is. That's the one synth I want to create. Kind of got close enough. Alright, that's what we want there. Okay. Alright, so let's do. Okay. I'm actually really happy. Like, I had an idea of a sound I wanted and I was able to get it. So now we wanna. So thinking about the scene again, where like people are being hurt. My idea of this theme is like it's been good, and for some reason there've been like it's like people having this false perception of the Pokemon world, like people like visiting another country, and so like somebody going to the Pokemon, like going to the Pokemon world excited about everything and like starting to see accidents, and then like this overwhelming realization of, oh wait, this is not good, you know, like having these Pokemon around actually is hazardous to the lives of humans. So I think this is it. It's like the protagonist is seeing more and more incidents happening, and it's like the evidence of like this is not good is overwhelming. But do. Sound like the Flintstones. Big hits here. Play. I'm definitely not gonna get anything. Like I said, this is synthesis. We're working on synthesizing, and synthesizing is hard for me. So something that would I'd normally be able to get through quickly, it's not gonna happen today. I want some big hits. It may be like a bass drop. Let's do Earthquake Ensemble. On one side, clone. Here we go to me not labeling things. Negato. There we go. I think we have to lose. 2, 3, 4, 2, 3. I know that sounds so cheesy. Actually, we're gonna do Earthquake on both sides. Just use a different loop. Different sample. We have there's a D here. I think we're gonna get rid of that and maybe make it more subtle rather than being like nah, nah, nah. I think it's too on the nose. Like a reverse 808 sound. Stop with that. Stretch it out. Jazz, you're an idiot. It's not gonna go new. Hear anything with this. It's a bass drop. I don't know why I did a kick. So for a bass drop, we're gonna do like a 303. Alright, we're gonna have a portamento down to here. Put a little slide. Porter C1. Alright. Let's see how it sounds. Nothing happened. Oh, you know why? Because normally I do this thing right here. too long. Take too long. Doom. Doom. That's it. Doom. That's it. Doom. Hey, a lot of bass happening here. So imagining like woman chicken, help, help my son. He's dying, and like people splashing around to help them, and it transitions to like another one where a guy is getting chased by a Charizard right now. I think this needs to. Make sure it has a, like a nice little tail. Alright, so you got. Alright, so the woman, help, help my son! People are running around, help! She's like screaming. Then you can switch to a guy running through a forest, screaming for help as a Charizard is like blowing flames at him, and then switches to the next scene right there. Next scene would be a. Actually, I think the scene, it would be the woman calling the woman. First would be the woman with her child who was electrocuted. Then it would chance into the scene of the woman who's in the Antarctic, I guess, trying to fight off Dugong, I'm assuming. Like, it's getting freezing cold. I'm trying to figure out how the Dugong scene would work, but then we... Transition here would be the Charizard. Mm-hmm. Trying to think of how we want the Charizard scene to go. Doom, 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 doom. Maybe, oops. Mm-hmm. I think we have some percussion here. No. Mm-hmm. I think more hi-hatty stuff versus like. Trying to think of how the percussion could go for the Charizard. It's a lot. Okay, that's very. Don't. I want to be faster. Pick it up here. Not too much. Oh, that's too fast. Still too fast. There we go. I'm gonna curve some of this off. Sorry about the disconnection. No, what happened to my internet, but okay. Alright, so we got a bunch of. Got a lot of hi hat stuff is happening in my head. This is gonna sound best. I'm gonna keep that loop. So we got. Need a clothes. All these are bad. I want to be more hi-hatty. Let's, right now I'm thinking of the Charizard aspect of this. I want. Like hi-hat, like feel. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4. Record this on a different ASIO driver. You won't hear anything. Oh, that was really bad. 2, 2, 3, and 4, and ah, come on. 2, 3, 4. Fine. Sorry. 2, 3, 4. Deck the deck, back at the back, deck the cat. Look at the. We have deck at the cat, but the cat, 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 switch over. What we got here? I want some like one E and one E. Okay. So I'm like. Something that is reminiscent of I don't know if that really sounds aggressive. Like, the Charizard start. The scene of the Charizard chasing the person starts here. I don't know if that feels aggressive enough. I think I need, like, a very loud. Need something aggressive here. Thank you. bitier. I think we want to go with saw. The like. I want bite. Preset isn't really doing it for me. I want something like really, really bitey. Like something like this. Sorry. So I want it to sound. Yeah. But I want it to sound like it. I want it to be sound cavernous. We have a bunch of those. But I want it to be swamp. I want it to be soaking in reverb. So let's try and get another cavernous. It's not exactly what I want. But let's see. I have lots of layers here, I think. Okay, darn it. I kind of have an idea of what I want. Things really need to get big here. Sounds scary to me. Let's do a 2, 3, 4. It's not hitting, like, it should be, like, layered with something else. Something, I think, brighter, maybe? No. Looking for a leady thing. Uh-huh. No. Change the the pitches at the regular. Okay. Let's have the pitch some. Do it. I don't know if it's going to be cavernous enough, but... Ooh, yeah! That sounds good to me. Ooh, what about the battle theme? Ah, it sounds so cheesy to get it in there. It sounds cheesy to me, but then we have a better approach to this. Boom. Oh my god, looking for drums. Alright, next, I'll finish this up in the next. Do, 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 do. In the world? Thank you. All right. Two things I want to do. So cheesy when I put the Pokemon theme in there, but to let you know it's deadly Pokemon, we gotta have it somewhere, right? I did a little bit of editing on the strings. I kind of want to do a full timbre to it. Cool. So I put a fuzz fuzzer over it. Listen to it again. No, I'm doing too much. All right, we're gonna listen to it from beginning to end, see how we feel about it. Okay. All right, so this is basically my prompt. A man sits in a burn ward to a rampaging Charizard. A woman lost half her hand from frostbite to dugong. A child is in a catatonic state from swimming too close to tentacrul's fingers. These are the untold stories of the Pokemon world, and the way the scene plays out in my head is, I guess I can, I'll pantomime this audio as it goes along, like how the scenes of this quote-unquote fake movie are, like, making themselves known in my head. So I think how it starts is, the order it's going is, it's going in the order of a child who... Let's say we've been watching the movie, and up to this point, the child has been swimming close to tentacrul, and the child got stung. So right now, we're in the midst of, like, the mom finding the child and, like, screaming help. Then we're going to transition to another scene where a woman is basically being trapped in by a dugong. I think maybe she's camping close to a dugong, like, I don't know, like breeding ground, and you know, and the dugong is basically trying to starve her out, make her freeze to death out there. And then it transitions to the Charizard scene, where a man is basically trying to, like, run away from a Charizard, you know, and is slowly being roasted alive. So here we go. So this is the mom who's got her child screaming, "Help! Help! Could someone please help?" You hear people running around. Then it switches to a woman who, like, you know, doesn't have any clothes, her hands are shaking, and then Charizard. Man runs the forest, Charizard. Just back to the woman holding her child. Back to the woman frantically trying to, you know, escape the encampment. And then it ends with the man tripping and falling. Charizard blows breath. Alright, there we go. My initial attempt. To be honest, this is my initial attempt at tackling this particular prompt. Very interesting. Very proud of myself for, like, getting all of these, for achieving my goal. One tune I wanted to craft from scratch, which was my deep synth slide, and I did it.
I freaking did it.
So, it only gets easier from here. And also, I want to say that I love how I was getting an idea of what I wanted sound wise, and I was able to attenuate the knobs to kind of give me that sound. So I definitely am getting better at the synthesis stuff. Very proud. So, yeah, that's all we've got for our warm-up today. Generally, what I would do is, I'll spend, like, 5 minutes, just chatting with folks before I log off officially to, like, jump into work. So, throw that my way. I'll be doing the chat thing. And for those who are just watching the video, we're at an end. So, till next time, later.